Melanie Chisholm, I don't know her as that, we all know her as Mel C, is about to become the first of the Spice Girls to star in a West End musical, and she's with us this morning. It's her first TV interview since having baby Scarlett.
Yes.
Are you nervous about getting back on the telly?
I am. I'm really nervous.
No.
Yeah. Well, loads of people watch this, don't they?
I hope so.
Including
I really
my little
hope
girl
so.
This morning.
Is she?
Yeah.
Is she?
Morning, Scarlett.
Is she six months or?
She's nearly 8 months.
Nearly
actually.
8 months. Okay.
Yeah.
And how is it?
It is everything that everybody says. It's wonderful, incredible, and very difficult.
Yes.
But you know, all the great things outweigh all the tough bits.
And are there teeth?
Teeth are coming, yes.
That's another quite demanding time,
yes,
isn't it?
Yeah.
What have you learnt since having a baby? So what's been the main thing, really? It's a real shock to the system, isn't it?
It's a real shock to the system. And even though, you know, people try to prepare you, friends who've had children, yeah, and your parents and stuff, you don't know till it actually happens to you.
Yeah.
I just think the early days, it's just so exhausted.
Sure.
It's really, really hard work. But, you know, now it's so rewarding because she's so much fun. She's a real character. So
we've just been doing this thing about reading. We had the government's sort of communication champion on. Do you sort of read and talk and sing?
We do. We have our bedtime routine, which, you know, I think most parents believe that is you've got to do it.
Yeah.
And, we like reading our books. Yeah. She's just stopped eating them, so that's quite good. She looks at the pictures.
They're all chewed. Don't throw anything away. Do you keep a diary as well? I know you're really tired. I wish I had. My kids are 16 and 15 now.
They just change so quickly.
They do. And it happens very, very fast. You're a busy girl coming up, aren't you?
Yes.
I mean, as if you haven't been busy anyway with your first child. You're in Blood Brothers.
Yes.
Tell us about that. How did that come about?
Well, it's funny, really. You know, the West End is something I've always really wanted to do. You know, we're so lucky here in the UK.
True.
Because we've got such a fantastic, you know, theatre land. And people come from all over the world to come and see shows at the West End. Blood Brothers has always been my favourite show. It's such a fantastic show. It was written by Willie Russell, which people know. If they don't know the show, they'll know Educating Rita and Shirley Valentine.
Sure.
So it's hysterically funny. You know, the characters are fantastic. The songs are great. And I always dreamed of this role.
Really. But now you've got to do it.
No, I've got to do it. I know. It's like the reality of it is quite daunting, but the cast are incredible. Everyone has been so lovely to me, and I'm in very good hands.
And when do you start?
I start on Monday the 26th is my opening night, so a week on Monday.
It's happening.
It's happening.
It's
I know.
Happening.
It's. You know what I want to say? After having a child, this is the biggest challenge of my life. It's the biggest professional challenge of my life.
Yeah. And, of course, it's all a prelude to the new Spice Girls tour and the new albums that you're going to be doing, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, we always meet in very public places to discuss very private matters. You know, the thing is, Melanie was in town, Jerry was around, you know, me and Emma are often here.
Yeah.
And, we just thought, let's get together, have a girly night. And, of course, the tabloids go bonkers. So.
Can you believe the impact the Spice Girls had? I mean, when you think about it, I mean, it's absolutely amazing, is it? Round the world.
Yeah.
I mean, you are, I think, the third most successful songwriter after Lennon McCartney, someone else, and then you.
Oh, there's lots of silly statistics about things, isn't there? Mm. You know, it is incredible, and you do still pinch yourself. And, you know, now I'm just very, very proud.
Yeah.
And it's something that will never be forgotten. And, you know, you're part of history, so that's really nice.
So is there a reunion or not?
No, there's on the cards at all. I mean, you know, I'm in the West End now for 6 months.
Yes.
I'll be there. Everyone's busy, you know. Emma's doing her radio show. Of course, Victoria's doing all her fashion line. So everyone's busy. Mel's dead busy.
The only Jerry's reunion will be busy. At a restaurant.
Yeah.
For another drink sometime soon.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's good. Very best of luck with everything.
Can I just mention another couple of things?
Yeah.
I'm doing two charity performances at the Royal Albert Hall.
Right.
One is a PRS show for Musicians Benevolent Fund.
Yeah.
That's on the 25th of
November.
October.
October.
Sunday, week on Sunday. And importantly, on the 1st of November, I'm doing a show there, Women of Rock, for the Hard Rock Cafe. It's Karen Keating Foundation.
Oh, great. Okay. And Gloria Hannaford hosting there, no doubt.
Absolutely.
Mel, good to see you.
Thank you very, very much.
Great. Love to Scarlett.